السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الشيخ مفتي.
I don't hear the response from that side. السلام عليكم. ما شاء الله. Now I don't hear it from this side here. السلام عليكم. ما شاء الله تبارك الله.
يا شيخ مفتي.
شيخ مفتي. Yes brother. Yes brother.
It's very very comfortable.
I think if we stand, mashallah, it will be much better. Barakallah fiqh. He speaks quite a lot of English, by the way, mashallah.
Yes, yes.
Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahumma ja'al ijtima'ana hadha ijtima'an marhuma.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this gathering.
واجعل تفرقنا من بعدي تفرقا معصوما.
And may he allow us to disperse after this inshallah in a way that we're forgiven.
وما يدريكم إخواني وأخواتي.
And you don't know, you wouldn't know my brothers and sisters.
لعلنا نلتقي في يوم من الأيام على أنهار الجنة.
Perhaps we may meet one of the days on one of the rivers of Jannah al-Firdaus.
ويكون العمل الذي أرضى الله عز وجل عنا وأدخلنا الجنة هذا المجلس.
And perhaps the deed that may have granted us entry into Jannah by the mercy of Allah may be this particular gathering.
فمن هيأ لنا هذا الاجتماع هو الله.
So he who facilitated this for us is Allah.
ومن اختارنا هو الله.
And the one who chose us is Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
ومن وفقنا هو الله.
And the one who has granted us acceptance is Allah.
ومن أتى بنا إلى هذا المكان هو الله.
The one who brought us to this place is Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
الحمد لله.
So say الحمد لله الحمد لله. Say الحمد لله. ما شاء الله.
الحمد لله كلمة عظيمة.
الحمد لله, all praise is due to Allah. That is a very powerful statement.
أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنها تملأ الميزان.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed us that it fills the entire scale.
وأخبر بأنها تملأ ما بين السماء والأرض.
And that it fills from the heavens or between the heavens and the earth completely.
وأنها من الباقيات الصالحات.
And it is one of the good deeds that remain.
بل هي من أحب الكلام إلى الله.
But it is one of the, in fact, it is one of the most loved statements unto Allah.
Everybody say Alhamdulillah.
Everyone say Alhamdulillah. قولوا الحمد لله.
إخواني في الله.
My brothers and sisters in Allah.
إنني أحبكم في الله.
I love you all for the sake of Allah.
أحسن الظن بالله.
Have a good perception of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
ربما هذا المجلس المبارك.
Perhaps this gathering blessed of ours.
يكون سببا لنا في دخول الجنة.
Can be a reason for us to enter Jannah al-Firdaus.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of that is.
وأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون.
The people of paradise will meet each other asking each other a question.
قالوا إنا كنا قبل في أهلنا مشفقين.
They will say to each other that before, prior, we were with our families back there, back in the dunya.
فمن الله علينا.
So indeed Allah has favored us, Allah has blessed us and favored us.
فمن الله علينا ووقانا عذاب السموم.
So indeed Allah has bestowed his favor upon us and he has saved us from the painful punishment.
إنا كنا من قبل ندعوه.
We used to in the past call out to him.
إنه هو البر الرحيم.
Indeed, he is the truthful, the most fulfilling of his word, and at the same time most merciful to the believers.
أهل الجنة يتقابلون في الجنة.
The people of paradise will be meeting each other in paradise. May Allah make us from among them. Say Amin.
فيسألون بعضهم بعضا.
So they will be asking each other questions.
ما هو سبب دخولنا الجنة؟
What was the reason for us to enter Jannah? How did we get into Jannah?
فيقول قائل منهم.
So one of them will say,
بمجلس جلسناه في الدنيا.
Because of a certain gathering that we sat on earth.
فذكرنا الله.
So we remembered Allah.
فغفر الله لنا.
So Allah forgave our sins.
وأكرمنا بدخول الجنة.
And honored us by granting us entry into جنة الفردوس.
من أجل ذلك أحسن الظن بالله.
This is why I say have a good perception of Allah who is the most merciful.
ربما يكون هذا المجلس المبارك سببا لنا في دخول الجنة.
Perhaps this particular gathering could be that for us. Allah might grant us جنة الفردوس as a result. سبحان الله.
وهذا يا أخي المجلس قد يكون سبب في نقطة تحول لنا وتجديد علاقتنا مع الله.
A gathering like this, my beloved brothers and sisters, could be the reason for us to change our lives, and it could be a reason for us to change our ways and habits, turn back to Allah, and get return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, achieve His happiness.
لأن الله عز وجل قال في القرآن.
Because Allah says in the Quran.
وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع من.
And remind, for indeed the reminding benefits a certain category. Which category?
تنفع من?
Who does the reminding benefit?
تنفع المؤمنين.
The reminding benefits those who truly believe.
من ينتفع بالذكرى.
Those who are benefited by a reminder.
إذا ذكر بالله عز وجل.
Whenever they are reminded about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
هم أهل الإيمان.
They are the ones who have belief. They are the ones who have faith.
فإذا وجدت نفسك بعد سماع الآيات وبعد سماع حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تتغير إلى الأفضل وتقبل على الله فهذا دليل على الإيمان.
So if you find yourself having changed, having benefited from the verses when they are read, if you find your heart softening, and if you find yourself feeling positive when you hear the verses of the Quran, and when you hear what the Prophet, peace be upon him, had to say, then you should know that you are from among those who believe, because it is only the believers who have that feeling within them.
والدليل على ذلك,
and the evidence of it is,
إنما تُنذِرُ من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب.
Indeed, you warn those who fear Allah in the unseen, those who follow the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the ones who take that as a warning and a reminder. The others don't.
أريد أن أبشر بشرى.
He says, I want to give you some good news, mashallah.
Allah, من كرمه وجوده وفضله, كتب على نفسه الرحمة.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His virtue, from His favor, and from His goodness and kindness, He has written upon Himself that He shall be merciful.
وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ.
Allah says, when the believers come to you, when those who believe in our verses come to you, then greet them with peace be upon you. Greet them with salamun alaykum. This was an instruction to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. كتب ربكم على نفسه الرحمة.
When those who believe in our verses come to you, greet them with the greeting, peace be upon you. For indeed Allah has written upon him that he will be merciful.
أنه من عمل منكم سوءا بجهالة ثم تاب.
Allah says, anyone from amongst you who has committed sin in the period of ignorance, in the time when they were ignorant, and then they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ثم تاب من بعده وأصلح.
If they were to repent to Allah and change their ways, making them good.
فأنا إنه غفور رحيم.
So indeed they will find him to be the most merciful, the most forgiving.
يا إخواني ويا أخواتي, نحن لن ندخل الجنة إلا إذا رحمنا الله.
My brothers and sisters, none of us will enter Jannah unless and except if Allah has mercy upon us.
والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال للصحابة رضوان الله عليهم ولأمته من بعدهم.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba, to his companions, and to the Ummah who were to follow later.
لن تدخل الجنة بأعمالكم.
You will not enter paradise due to your deeds.
قالوا ولا أنت يا رسول الله.
They said, what about you, O Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال ولا أنا إلا أن يتداركنا الله برحمته.
He says, not even me unless Allah has had mercy on myself and all of us.
يسأل سائل ويقول.
A questioner questions and asks.
إن كان نحن لن ندخل الجنة إلا برحمة الله.
If we are not going to enter paradise except by the mercy of Allah,
فلماذا نعمل?
So why do we have to do deeds? Moments ago he said that if you do deeds or our deeds will not be able to get us into paradise except through the mercy of Allah. So the question is, so why then should we do deeds?
الإنسان لن يحصل على رحمة الله إلا إذا عمل أعمال صالحة توجب له محبة الله ورحمة الله.
A person will never be able to achieve the mercy of Allah unless they do the deeds that will call on the mercy of Allah. So when you do your deeds, you actually then call on the mercy of Allah for Allah to have mercy on you as a result of you doing the deeds for the sake of Allah.
لذلك الله عز وجل في القرآن الكريم والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في سنته ذكروا لنا أعمال كثيرة إذا فعلناها وجبت لنا رحمة الله.
And this is why in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, and in the hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has spoken about in so many places deeds that if you were to do them you would be able to achieve the mercy of Allah, because it is through that mercy that you will then get paradise.
لذلك نحن سنذكر بعض الآيات وبعض الأحاديث التي فيها أعمال. إذا عملنا هذه الأعمال يرحمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى لأننا نريد أن نكون عمليين.
So we want to make mention of those verses of the Quran and some of the ahadith or the statements of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wherein there are deeds that would achieve the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, because we want to be practical.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة الأعراف.
Allah says in سورة الأعراف.
ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء.
My mercy has definitely included absolutely everything.
يقول أحد الصالحين في هذه الآية. يا من رحمتك وسعت كل شيء عبدك شيء من الأشياء فاغفر له ورحمه.
One of the predecessors has said that, O you whose mercy has encompassed absolutely everything, I want you to know that this worshipper is one of the things included in the term everything.
الله جل وعلا قال فسأكتبها, أي هذه الرحمة.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I will write this mercy, I will prescribe it for those. The mercy, Allah says he will prescribe it for those whom.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
I will write the mercy for those who are conscious of me, those who engage in piety, those who are pious, who try hard to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ. وَالتَّقْوَى أَن تَجْعَلَ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ وِقَايَةً.
Allah says he will prescribe it for those whom have the taqwa in them, and the term taqwa, the meaning of it includes to create a barrier between yourself and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing good deeds and abstaining from bad deeds.
بِفِعْلِ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ.
By doing that which is in obedience with Allah.
وترك ما حرم الله.
And quitting that which Allah has prohibited.
والثبات حتى الممات.
And to remain steadfast on that up to death as far as possible.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
So Allah says, I have written this beautiful mercy of mine for those who have taqwa.
يقول علي بن أبي طالب.
علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه says,
يعرف التقوى فيقول,
he is giving the translation of taqwa and he says it means,
هي الخوف من الجليل.
It is the consciousness or the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
والرضا بالقليل.
And to be happy and content with the small provision in this world.
والعمل بالتنزيل.
And to practice upon revelation.
ومعنى التنزيل أي كتاب الله.
And revelation is obviously referring to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وسنة نبينا محمد.
And the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل.
And to prepare for the day that you are going to leave. You are going to go leave from this earth and enter into the hereafter.
هذه هي التقوى.
This is the meaning of taqwa. This is what taqwa means.
لن يدخل أحدكم الجنة إلا إذا تمسك بهذه التقوى.
We cannot enter into paradise unless and until we try our best to hold as fast as possible onto this taqwa.
تلك الجنة.
That Jannah that Allah has prepared.
هذه الجنة العظيمة.
The paradise that is so great.
الذي فيها من النعيم الشيء العظيم.
That has in it from the gifts of Allah so many and so great.
الحور.
The حور.
الأنهار.
The rivers.
القصور.
The castles.
لذة النظر إلى وجه الله.
The sweetness at looking
الفرح.
To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the happiness.
كلها.
All of these things.
لن يدخلها إلا المتقين.
Only those with taqwa shall enter this Jannah.
والدليل.
And the evidence of it.
تلك الجنة التي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا.
This Jannah that we have prepared, we will grant it to our worshippers, those who had taqwa.
اللهم اجعلنا من أهل التقوى.
May Allah make us from among those who have taqwa. Say amen.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
Going back to that verse, Allah says, we have written this mercy for those who have this taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And they give alms to the poor, the charities. They are charitable with what Allah has given them.
هذا العمل الثاني الذي يوجب لك رحمة الله. الزكاة والصدقة بشكل عام.
This is the second deed that would actually be able to achieve the mercy of Allah. A person will achieve the mercy of Allah by doing this deed as well. It is being charitable. Zakah actually refers to two things. One is to cleanse oneself, and two is to be charitable and to be able to give others from what Allah gave you. If you're ready to do that, you will achieve the mercy of Allah. You share what Allah has given you.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال,
the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said,
الصدقة تطفئ غضب الرب كما يطفئ الماء النار.
Charities extinguish the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same way that water extinguishes fire.
وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة ليس بتمرة كاملة وإنما ولو بنصف تمرة.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said, be conscious or be fearful of the hellfire even if it meant by a portion of a date, not the whole date, just half of it, a portion of it.
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ممن نفعه وساهم في خدمة الدين والإسلام والمسلمين أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of those who helped him and stood by him and assisted him in fulfilling this beautiful mission, was a man known as Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه.
أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه في بداية الإسلام كان هناك بعض فقراء الصحابة الذين أسلموا.
At the beginning of Islam, there were a few poor people who had accepted Islam.
كانوا رقيق عبيد.
They were enslaved at the time. They were slaves.
فحينما أسلموا وآمنوا قام بعض ساداتهم بتعذيبهم.
So when they had accepted Islam, some of their masters happened to punish them as a result of them accepting Islam.
فكان أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه يأتي بماله ويشتري هذا الصحابي من سيده ويعتقه لوجه الله.
So Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه used to come with some of his own wealth and he used to purchase the freedom of these people and free them for the sake of Allah so that they would no longer be under the ownership of those people. They would be free to worship Allah.
فجاء أبوه.
So one of the men, his father came.
وعاتبه.
In fact, the father of Abu Bakr came and scolded him.
وقال له يا أبا بكر.
And told him, Oh Abu Bakr.
لماذا تشتري هؤلاء وتعتق هؤلاء الضعفاء؟ اعتق أقوياء حتى ينفعونك في المستقبل.
Why are you freeing these weak people, those who are weak? Why don't you free those who are strong so that they can benefit you in the future?
فقال له أبو بكر رضي الله عنه أرضاه.
So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه said to him, to his own father.
قال يا أبتي إني أبتغي وجه الله.
He says, والله I'm only doing this for the sake of Allah.
فأنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى قوله.
So Allah has revealed the verse.
وسيجنبها الأتقى.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep away from the fire of hell those who were conscious, or the one who was conscious.
الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى.
The one who gave his wealth or gives his wealth in charity.
وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى.
And none could actually recompense such a person. They would not be doing it for any other purpose besides the pleasure of Allah.
إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى.
They would only be doing it in order to achieve the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى.
And very soon, inshallah, he will be happy. Meaning the one who has spent wealth will be saved from the fire, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them goodness, and at the same time they will be happy at the end.
أبشركم بشرى.
Says, I give you a piece of good news.
يا من تتصدقون لوجه الله.
O you who are spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إن الله سبحانه وتعالى يربي هذه الصدقة.
Allah will grant your charities growth.
كما يربي أحدكم فلوة.
Just like one of you would actually achieve growth of their plant.
حتى تصبح يوم القيامة مثل الجبال.
Until it will become like a whole mountain on the day of judgment.
لأن الله.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
أكرم الأكرمين.
Is the most honorable of the honored.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of it.
من جاء بالحسنة.
He or she who comes with a good deed on the day of judgment.
من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها.
Whoever comes with a good deed on the day of judgment, it will be multiplied for them tenfold.
من أجل ذلك أنتم تتعاملون مع الشكور.
And this is why we say that you are working with the one who recompenses and shows that gratitude in the biggest way.
من هو الشكور؟
Who is he who is most grateful?
الذي
He is the one
يجازي بالعمل القليل الأجر الكثير.
Who gives a recompense of a small deed in a very, very big way. That is Allah. One of his names is Ash-Shakur, because when you do something small, he actually gives you back in return much more than your little deed that you had done.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of it is
في سورة فاطر.
In Surah Fatir.
إِنَّ رَبَّنَا لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ.
Indeed, our Lord is most forgiving, most grateful, meaning he shows gratitude by multiplying that which you've done in a bigger way compared to what you've done.
قال أحد العلماء معلقا على هذه الآية.
One of the scholars have said regarding this verse.
إن ربنا لغفور شكور.
The same verse that he has made mention of.
غفر كثيرا من الزلل.
That Allah has forgiven so many sins.
وشكر قليلا من العمل.
And he has thanked very small deeds in a very, very big way.
الله أكبر. ما أكرمك يا الله.
Oh Allah, how great you are.
قال الله.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
That Allah has written this mercy for those who have taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And those who are charitable, they give.
نحن في هذه الدنيا بيننا وبين الشمس 150 مليون كيلومتر.
Us in this world, between us and the sun, there is 150 million kilometers.
أنتم في لندن لا تعرفون حرارة الشمس.
Here in London, you don't know what heat actually means.
نحن في السعودية نعرفها جيدا.
We in the Middle East know exactly what it is.
لأن درجة الحرارة عندنا تصل إلى 60 درجة حرارة.
Because where we come from, the temperature rises almost to 60 degrees.
وبيننا وبينها في الدنيا 150 مليون كيلو.
Yet there is 150 million kilometers between us and the sun.
لكن يوم القيامة.
But on the day of judgment.
هذه الشمس.
The sun.
ستدنو من رؤوس الخلائق مقدار ميل.
Will become so close to the heads of the human beings.
فيغرق الناس.
So people will be drowning
في عرقهم على قدر أعمالهم.
In their own sweat according to the deeds that they've done.
منهم من يكون إلى كعبيه.
Some of them their sweat will be up to the ankles.
ومنهم من يكون إلى ركبتيه.
Some of them up to their knees.
ومنهم إلى حقويه.
Some of them up to their waist.
ومنهم إلى منكبيه.
Some up to the shoulders.
ومنهم من يلجمه العرق الجم.
And some they will be drowning in their own sweat.
على قدر أعمالهم في الدنيا.
According to the deeds they've done, the bad deeds that they've done on earth.
لكن أبشركم بشارة.
But there is a piece of good news.
المؤمن يأتي تحت ظل صدقته يوم القيامة.
A believer will be shaded by the shade of the charity that he has given during his time on earth. So be charitable, my brothers and sisters.
الله أكبر.
وهناك سبع يظلهم الله تحت ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله.
And there is a narration where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم speaks of seven categories of people whom Allah will grant a special shade, the shade of His arsh, on the day that there will be no other shade besides that.
The first one,
الأولى.
يا سلام. شاب نشأ في طاعة الله.
A young person who had grown up and use that youth in the obedience of Allah.
إمام عادل.
A just ruler.
رجل تعلق قلبه بالمساجد.
A man whose heart is connected to the masjid.
رجلان تحابا في الله اجتمعا عليه وتفرقا عليه.
Two people who love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they gather in his love and they depart in the same.
ورجل.
And a person.
دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال.
Who is called to commit adultery by the opposite sex.
فقال لها إني أخاف الله.
And he says that indeed I fear Allah. Or she says.
ورجل.
And a person.
ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه من الدم.
Who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone when they're alone and their eyes are filled with tears. Remember, this is for male and female together. Not every yes. time the hadith says rajul, does it mean man. That, some of you might be noticing the translation. I'm not making a mistake.
That's right. Good, sir.
Alhamdulillah.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
What a beautiful verse, subhanallah. Allah says,
wait, my brother.
I've written the mercy for those who have taqwa.
Wait, my brother. The seventh one.
Okay, the seventh one, yes. أهم حاجة.
رجل أنفق بيمينه ولم تعلم شماله ماذا أنفق.
A person who has given a charity with his or her right hand in such a way that even the left hand doesn't know what the right hand did. What that means is that when we spend, we actually spend without advertising that we've given. We want nothing in return besides the pleasure of Allah. We don't want perks, we don't want acknowledgements, nothing. Allah knows, we know, and that's it. Yeah, some people think that what it means is you must put your left hand behind your back whenever you are giving a charity.
لا ولكن
that's not what it means.
أن يكون نيته خالصة لوجه الله ولا يعلم به أحد من البشر.
It means that the intention needs to be for the sake of Allah alone, and no one knows besides the minimum. Like for example, the one you've given may know. Subhanallah.
فنسأل الله أن يظلنا تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ظل إلا.
So we ask Allah to grant us the shade of His arsh on the day that there will be no shade besides that particular shade.
نرجع مرة أخرى نذكر إخواننا بالأعمال التي تجلب لنا رحمة الله.
We return to the topic of speaking of the deeds that will result in drawing the mercy of Allah.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
So we will write the mercy upon those who have taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And those who fulfill their charities.
والذين هم بآياتنا يؤمنون.
And those who believe with conviction in our verses and signs.
يؤمنون بآيات الله ويعملون بمقتضى هذه الآيات.
They believe in revelation in the verses that Allah has revealed, and they work upon these beautiful verses and instructions of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
فإن الله لم ينزل إلينا هذه الآيات العظيمة إلا من أجل أن نتفكر فيها ونتأمل فيها ونعمل بها.
So Allah has not revealed these verses except for us to look into them and learn them and think about them and take lesson from them.
لا نريد أن نقرأها مثل ما نقرأ المجلات والجرائد.
We don't want to read the Quran just like we read a magazine or the newspapers.
نريد أن نقرأها ونعمل بها.
We want to read it and we want to act upon it.
والدليل على ذلك.
The evidence of that.
كتاب أنزلناه مبارك.
A book that we have revealed to you that is very, very blessed.
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته.
A book that we have revealed to you that is blessed. Talking about the Quran, the reason of that revelation is for its verses to be pondered over.
ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب.
In order that the verses be pondered over and it can be a reminder for those with sound intellect. That is the purpose of revelation of this Quran.
إن هذا القرآن العظيم.
This great Quran.
كلام من.
Is the word of whom?
الله.
كلام من.
الله الله.
كلام الله.
It's the word of Allah.
بواسطة أعظم الملائكة من.
It was sent down through the greatest of angels, and who was he?
جبريل.
جبريل عليه السلام.
ثم نزل على قلب أفضل البشر من.
Then it came down into the heart of the best of humankind. Whom?
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
صلى الله عليه.
ثم نزل في أعظم الشهور شهر رمضان.
Then it was sent in the most blessed of months. That's the month of Ramadan.
ثم نزل في أعظم الليالي ليلة القدر.
Then in the most blessed of the nights of Ramadan, and that is ليلة القدر.
والله والله لو نزل القرآن في قلبي وفي قلوبكم لأصبحنا أفضل البشر.
Wallahi, if this Quran has to enter into our hearts, my heart, your hearts, we will become the best of the people.
وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ آيَاتٍ مُبَيِّنَاتٍ.
Allah says, and indeed we have revealed to you clear-cut verses.
وَمَثَلًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِن قَبْلِكُمْ.
And similitudes of those who have passed before you.
وَمَوْعِظَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
And a reminder for those who have taqwa, who are conscious of Allah.
اللهم اجعلنا ممن يقرأ هذا الكلام ويتأمل معانيه.
May Allah make us from those who read the Quran and who ponder over its meaning. Amin. Say Amin.
من عظمة القرآن عند الله سبحانه وتعالى
from the greatness of the Quran
أن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل الاستماع والإنصات للقرآن سببا لرحمة الله.
الله أكبر. From the greatness of this beautiful Quran that Allah has revealed is that Allah has kept the mercy of Allah specially for those who listen attentively and keep quiet when the Quran is being recited. Just by listening to the Quran.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of it is.
وإذا قرئ القرآن.
Whenever the Quran is read.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا.
Whenever the Quran is read, then listen very attentively and keep quiet.
فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Then listen very attentively and keep quiet in order that you achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَمِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ الَّتِي تُوجِبْ لَنَا رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ.
And one of the deeds that would actually call on the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
ta'atullah wa ta'atul rasul sallallahu alayhi
to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's instructions and that of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
What dalil?
And the evidence of it
wa ati'u Allah wa ar-rasul.
Follow Allah and follow his messenger.
Wa ati'u Allah wa ar-rasul.
Follow Allah, follow his messenger.
وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
The verse says, follow Allah, follow his messenger, in order that you may achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
Again back to the verse. Allah says he will write the mercy for those who have taqwa, who are conscious of him.
وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ.
And those who are charitable.
وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ.
And those who believe in our verses and signs.
الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل.
Those who follow the prophet, those who follow the prophet who was sent to them, the prophet who was unlettered, and those who follow him who was mentioned in the Torah and the Injil before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they are the ones whom who will achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يَأْمُرُهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ.
What does he instruct? The messenger instructs them to do good and prohibits them from doing bad.
وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ.
And he makes permissible that which is good and pure.
وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ.
And he prohibits everything that is impure and unclean.
وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ.
And he breaks them free from the shackles that were upon them.
فالذين آمنوا به وعزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور.
Those who have followed him, those who have believed in him, and those who have followed the light.
وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعَهُ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ.
And those who have followed the light, meaning the Quran that was revealed to him, they are indeed the ones who will definitely be successful.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ذكر لنا في القرآن.
Allah has mentioned in the Quran
أقوام فعلوا جرائم عظام.
About nations that have done great crimes.
ورغم ما فعلوا إن إلا أن الله فتح لهم باب الأمل والرحمة ولم يقنطهم من رحمته.
And even those who have done so much in terms of wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still showed them the doors of forgiveness and the doors of His mercy.
أصحاب الأخدود في نجران في منطقة عندنا في جنوب المملكة.
Those أصحاب الأخدود who happened to be in the southern part of Saudi Arabia many many years back.
حفروا خندقا عظيما.
They dug a huge trench.
وأشعلوا فيه نارا.
And they lit a fire.
وجعلوا هذه النار وهذا الخندق لكل من آمن بالله.
And they said, anyone who believes in Allah, we will cast them into this.
إما أن يؤمن إما أن يكفر بالله وإما أن يلقى في هذه النار.
Either they disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they will be thrown into this fire that we've made.
وبدأوا يحضرون الرجال والنساء.
And they started bringing the men and the women forth.
من يكفر يعود ومن يستمر على إيمانه يلقى في النار.
Whoever said they were disbelievers, they were told you can go back, it's fine. Whoever said they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the men and the women, they were thrown into the fire.
وأحرقوا عباد الله المؤمنين.
And they burnt a lot of people who believed.
رغم ذلك لم يقنطهم الله من رحمته.
But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make them lose hope in His mercy.
وهذا الكلام في القرآن.
And this is in the Quran. Allah makes mention of it in the Quran.
في سورة البروج.
In Surah Al-Buruj.
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات.
Those who have tried, tested the believing males and females, meaning those criminals who had burnt those males and females from among the believers.
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا.
Those who had perpetrated those crimes against the believing males and females, and then they did not repent from those sins.
فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق.
They will have the punishment of hellfire, and they will be the ones who will burn.
كفار قريش.
The kuffar of Quraysh, the people of Quraysh.
ماذا فعلوا بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
What did they do to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
وماذا فعلوا بالصحابة؟
What did they do to the companions of رسول الله؟
شتموهم.
They swore them.
وكذبوه.
They belied them.
وعذبوا الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم.
They punished the companions who believed.
وحاولوا قتل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And they tried to kill the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقاتلوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة.
And they fought the Prophet and his companions.
وقتلوا 70 من صحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزوة واحدة.
And they executed or killed 70 of the companions in one of the battles.
وشجوا وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكسروا ربعيته.
And they caused injury to the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and broke his tooth.
وعبدوا الأصنام.
And they worshipped whatever they did.
وشربوا الخمور.
They drank alcohol intoxicants.
وفعلوا جرائم لا تعد ولا تحصى.
They perpetrated crimes and committed sins that we lost count of.
بماذا أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بماذا أمر الله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يقول لهم؟
What did Allah tell the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to tell those type of people?
قل للذين كفروا إن ينتهوا يغفر لهم ما قد سلف.
Say to those who have disbelieved that if they stop and if they turn, Allah will forgive every single thing that they've done in the past.
قل للذين كفروا إن ينتهوا يغفر لهم ما قد سلف وإن يعودوا فقد مضت سنة الأولين.
And if they were to return to their old ways and habits, then indeed the lessons of the past are all there.
المنافقون في المدينة.
The hypocrites of Medina Munawwara.
كانوا يبطنون الكفر ويظهرون الإسلام.
They used to pretend to be Muslims, but they were not.
وهم من أخطر الناس على الإسلام والمسلمين.
And they were the most dangerous against the Muslims and against Islam.
كانوا يقفون في صف المشركين واليهود ضد الإسلام والمسلمين.
They used to stand with the enemies against Islam.
ومع ذلك والله سبحانه وتعالى أخبر بأن من يموت على النفاق سيكون في الدرك الأسفل من النار.
And Allah says, whoever dies upon hypocrisy, where they were showing something that wasn't in terms of hiding the disbelief and pretending to be believers, they will be in the lowest level of hellfire.
ومع ذلك
And still Allah says,
لم يقنطهم الله من رحمته.
He did not make them lose hope in his mercy.
والدليل على ذلك في سورة النساء.
And the evidence of it is in سورة النساء.
إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار.
Indeed, the hypocrites, the munafiqeen, will be in the lowest, lowest possible levels of hellfire.
تجد لهم نصيرا.
You will never find anyone to help them.
ثم استثنى الله عز وجل من تاب.
But Allah makes an exception from amongst them of who repents to Him.
إلا الذين تابوا وأصلحوا واعتصموا بالله.
Except, meaning from among those hypocrites who would be punished, the exception is made of those who repent to Allah. They change their bad ways and they dedicate their lives to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَاعْتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ وَأَخْلَصُوا دِينَهُمْ لِلَّهِ.
Those who hold fast unto what Allah has revealed and those who turn back to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants.
فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
Those will now be considered as, or they will be with the true believers.
وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا.
And indeed, Allah will favor the true believers with a great, great, great reward.
الآن سمعتم في القرآن رحمة الله بمن كفروا من أصحاب الأخدود وعذبوا المؤمنين.
So these examples, now you have just heard the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who had disbelieved and those who had harmed the mu'mins and the muslimin, those who had perpetrated crimes, that was Allah's offer to them and that was the mercy of Allah for them.
وسمعتم أيضا رحمة الله بمن آمن وتاب من كفار قريش.
And you've also heard about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon those from the kuffar of Quraysh who have accepted the deen and repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
هذا وأيضا سمعتم رحمة الله بالمنافقين.
And you've also heard about the mercy of Allah for those who were hypocrites if they were to change their ways and habits.
هذه رحمة الله بمن حاربوه.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have fought against him.
هذه رحمة الله بمن حاربوا أنبياءه وأولياءه.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have fought the messengers of Allah and his friends.
هذه رحمة الله بمن قتل عباد الله المؤمنين وحرقهم.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have killed the believers and who have burnt some of them as per the examples in the Quran.
فكيف هي رحمة الله بعباده المؤمنين إذا عادوا.
So what do you think is going to be the mercy of Allah to you and I, the worshippers of Allah, if we were to return to Allah?
اتصل بي في يوم من الأيام شاب من شباب المسلمين.
He says, one day I received a phone call from one of the youth from amongst the Muslims.
فقال لي.
And he told me,
أنا لا أظن أن الله سيغفر لي.
I don't think Allah will forgive me.
فسألته بعض الأسئلة.
I asked him a few questions.
هل كفرت بالله؟
Have you disbelieved in Allah?
قال لا.
He says no.
قلت له هل قتلت نفس حرمها الله؟
Have you killed someone? Have you murdered someone?
قال لا.
He says no.
هل فعلت الزنا والعياذ بالله؟ قال لا.
Have you committed adultery, fornication? He says no.
قلت له لو أشركت بالله وقتلت النفس التي حرم الله وفعلت هذا الزنا والعياذ بالله ثم عدت إلى الله لقبلك الله وغفر الله لك.
He says, I told him, if you were to engage in shirk and if you were to perpetrate the crimes, if you were to disbelieve in Allah, if you were to commit that adultery or fornication and you were to turn in repentance to Allah after that, Allah would forgive all of that.
وليس يغفرها لك وحسب.
And he would not just forgive you and that's it.
وإنما يبدل السيئات إلى حسنات.
But if you were to change your ways truly, he would convert your bad deeds into good deeds.
وهذا في القرآن.
And this is in the Quran.
في سورة الفرقان.
In سورة الفرقان.
والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر.
Allah makes mention of an exception after he speaks of the punishment. He says the exception is for those who do not call out to deities besides Allah.
ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق.
And they do not commit murder.
ولا يزنون.
And they do not commit adultery.
ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما.
Whoever does any of these things, they have committed a grave sin.
يضاعف له العذاب.
The punishment will be very severe for that person.
يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا.
The punishment will be very severe for that person, and they will dwell for a very long time in a very disgraceful place.
ثم استثنى سبحانه التائبين.
Then Allah made an exception of those who have repented to Allah. That's the exception I was speaking about earlier, where Allah says, after he makes mention of the punishment of all these, he says, except those who have repented. The acceptance is of those who have repented to Allah.
تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا.
Those who have done three things, they have repented to Allah and believed truly in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and changed their lives in a way that they have done good deeds thereafter.
فأولئك.
So those are the ones whom.
فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات.
Those are the ones whom Allah will convert their bad deeds into good deeds after that.
وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving, most merciful.
من الأعمال العظيمة التي توجب للإنسان رحمة الله ومحبة الله التوبة والعودة إلى الله.
One of the biggest ways of achieving the mercy of Allah, the deeds that would actually draw the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to seek the forgiveness of Allah and to return to Allah.
وهناك دليل من كتاب الله.
And there is evidence in the Quran.
في سورة البقرة.
In سورة البقرة.
إن الله يحب التوابين.
Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him.
إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين.
Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him and those who are pure and clean.
أنا أريد أن أسأل الشيخ منصور سؤال.
Says I want to ask Sheikh Mansour a question.
ما هي أرجى آية في القرآن؟
What is the most, the verse of the Quran that has in it the most hope?
أرجى آية في القرآن.
The verse with the most hope in the Quran.
كما قال ابن مسعود.
As per what Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه said.
هي آية في سورة الزمر.
It is a verse in سورة الزمر.
وقال الله.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى has said.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم.
Tell my worshippers, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O my worshippers, those who have transgressed against themselves, those who have sinned, no matter what sin they've committed.
لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله.
Never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إن إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا.
Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive every single sin that you've committed.
إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
For indeed he is most forgiving, most merciful.
هذا سؤالي للشيخ منصور وأجاب إجابة رائعة.
He says that was my question to Sheikh Mansour and he answered an awesome answer.
أنا الآن أريد أن أسألكم جميعا.
Says I want to ask all of you a question.
والمشاهدين.
All those who are present and all those who are seeing.
لو أنا طلبت منكم أمر وأنتم تستطيعون أن تعطوني هذا الأمر هل ستمتنعون؟
He says if I had to ask you for something and you were able to do that for me, would you say no if it was easy for you to do? Would you?
أكيد يمنعون.
No. He says well I think they would say no.
أنا.
إيش يقولون؟
He says I would say no.
I ask him.
Yes, he's saying that I asked you guys, not him. Yeah. MashaAllah.
تمام. ماذا قالوا؟
قالوا ما نرفض.
لماذا؟
He says, why would you not deny me?
ماذا قدمت لكم؟
What have I done for you?
أنا إنسان مثلي مثلكم.
I'm just like you. I've done nothing for you. What have I done for you? Sorry? Well, يقولون ذكرتمونا تذكير.
أنا لم أقدم لكم شيء. أنا أتيت هنا أقدم لنفسي لأني أريد النجاة من عند الله.
He says, I haven't done anything for you. If I've come and spoken, I've spoken in order to remind myself so that I can actually get closer to Allah.
ولكنكم جاوبتم واستجبتم لطلبي لأنكم كرماء.
But you have actually said that you would do what I've asked you to do because you are people of honor. Is that right? خلاص.
لو كان الطلب من الله لو كان الذي يريد منهم أمر الله وليس أنا ولله المثل الأعلى.
What if the one who was asking you for something that you can do is actually Allah, not just an ordinary human being, but Allah.
لو أنت تعلم بأن الله يريد منك أمر وأنت تستطيع أن تحقق هذا الأمر ماذا سيكون جوابك؟
If you know that Allah is asking you to do something and you can do it, what will your answer be?
Yes. الله سبحانه وتعالى يريد مني ومنكم جميعا أمر.
Allah wants from you and I something.
اسمعوا ماذا يريد الله عز وجل.
Listen to it.
والله يريد.
Allah wants the following.
والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم.
Allah wants to forgive you.
والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم.
Allah says clearly that Allah wants from you that He forgives you.
ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات.
And those who follow the whims and fancies and desires.
أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما.
They want you to turn away. They want you to turn far away.
الذكي.
The one who's intelligent.
العاقل.
The one who has a brain.
يختار.
Chooses.
ما أراده الله.
What Allah wants.
ليس ما أراده الشياطين.
And not what the shayateen and the devils want.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يريد أن يرحمنا.
Allah wants to have mercy on us.
أن يتوب علينا.
To forgive us.
أن يغفر لنا.
To forgive us.
أن يحبنا.
To love us.
أن يتجاوز عنا.
To expiate our sins.
أن يخفف عنا.
And to make easy for us.
أن يدخلنا الجنة.
And to grant us entry into Jannah.
وأهل الشهوات.
But as for those who are calling towards whims and fancies.
يريدون منا أن نميل ميلا عظيما.
They want us to turn away in a very bad way.
نحن مع من?
Who will we be with?
مع الله.
With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right?
Inshallah.
MashaAllah.
We will be back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Time out.